It might sound crazy now, but a century ago, many people believed that airships were a revolutionary new technology that would transform the world. They thought that airships, not airplanes, were the future of flying. Airplanes had just been invented, and they were terrible. Airplanes were slow, dangerous, loud, and miserably uncomfortable. Airships offered comfort and luxury. They were like cruise ships in the sky. Airships seemed so promising that when they built the Empire State Building, they added a docking station to board airships. It was never used because the reality was that airships were flying death traps. They often failed catastrophically, blowing up and killing their passengers. Despite their horrific safety record, people kept building airships, trying out new designs that fared no better. While airships kept falling out of the sky, airplanes steadily improved, getting so much safer and more comfortable, the airship idea was finally scrapped. But first, what is an airship? Airships are bigger than blimps. Blimps are tiny. Let's compare today's Goodyear blimp to an airship built 100 years ago. The airship is 27 times larger by volume and can lift 20 times more weight. It could carry 140 people in luxurious cabins versus a blimp with 6 people in a tight cabin. Blimps are just balloons. They have no internal structure, which limits their size. Oversized blimps will collapse on themselves. To build a giant airship, you need to build a skeleton. You need to build a hard metal frame holding in the gas bags. Airships are very different from airplanes. Many people thought that airships were better in 1930. At that time, airplanes were tiny. They held 20 passengers in a tight, cramped cabin. Airplanes were not pressurized, which means they couldn't fly very high. And if you can't fly very high, that means everyone's in for a bumpy ride. Airplanes were not fast. They needed to constantly refuel. In 1927, a British minister flew by plane to India, trying to show how simple and easy it was. He showed the opposite. It took him 12 days and 20 stops. An airship could complete that journey in 4 days and 1 stop. Airplanes were cramped, noisy, bumpy, and uncomfortable. In contrast, the airship is gigantic. It can carry 100 passengers and 40 crew. Everyone has their own sleeping cabin. It has dining rooms, promenades, and lounges. Its greatest luxury was it had a smoking lounge. It might seem crazy to be lighting up cigarettes just below a balloon filled with flammable gas. But you have to understand that in the 1920s, most men smoked, and it was not so easy to give that up for a long voyage. Airships offered comfort, luxury, and relaxation. Airships contained giant bags filled with hydrogen gas. Hydrogen is flammable. Another alternative is to use helium. Helium is safer since it does not burn, but there were big problems with helium. Helium is heavier than hydrogen, so it provides half the lifting power. But more importantly, helium was extremely difficult to find. In 1905, the entire world's supply of helium fit into 3 bottles sitting on a shelf at the University of Kansas. Helium was expensive to buy and to transport, and it was held mainly by Americans who didn't always feel like sharing it with other parts of the world, like Nazi Germany. On the other hand, hydrogen was cheap and easy to find. You can extract it from water. The hydrogen on the airship was stored in a dozen giant gas bags, holding 5 million cubic feet of hydrogen. Some bags were as tall as a 10-story building, and you'll never guess what they were made out of. Cow's intestines. At the time, intestines were actually the best material. You really don't want the bags to leak, and intestines were the least permeable material they could find. But the trade-off is that the bags were very fragile. On multiple occasions, men slipped and fell through the gas bags and out the other side. And to fill a giant airship, you need about 500,000 cow's intestines. The history of ballooning goes back centuries. The first manned hydrogen balloons were made in France in 1783. At the time, Benjamin Franklin was visiting France, and he watched the first balloon flight. Someone asked him, "What good are these new balloons?" Franklin replied, "What good is a newborn babe?" His point is, you shouldn't expect something new useful when it's born. Babies and new ideas take time to develop. For the next century, people kept tinkering with balloons, but they remained pretty small until Count von Zeppelin, from Germany, discovered how to supersize them by putting the gas bags inside a hard metal frame. After a few successful trials, von Zeppelin became world famous. In 1908, one of his airships exploded. The German people responded, not by criticizing or blaming Zeppelin. No, shockingly, they actually embraced Zeppelin as a national hero and showered him with money. Germany was gripped by Zeppelin fever. Zeppelin saw airships as military weapons. The first long-range bombers were not airplanes. They were airships. German airships bombed London during the First World War. These airships were pretty bad as military weapons. But German propaganda tricked people into thinking they were really good. Germany and Britain wasted lots of money on ineffective airships. At first glance, airships appeared to be safer than airplanes. Their slow, graceful movement hid their extreme danger. Airships routinely crashed, and despite their terrible safety record, they kept being built. The great enemy of airships is thunderstorms. During a storm, ships can head into harbor and airplanes can head for a runway. But airships have nowhere to go. In high winds, they're most vulnerable near the ground. During a storm, the airship's huge surface area acts like a giant sail. They can rise or fall uncontrollably, plunging thousands of feet in seconds. Airships are very difficult to operate. Pilots had to get just the right amount of lift to control the height. If the airship goes too low, it hits the ground. If the airship goes too high, its gas will expand, which will pop the balloons unless it's released. The airship's lift depends on many different things. The outside temperature, the inside gas temperature, the barometric pressure, the humidity, the purity of the gas. The lift would go down as the gas leaked. The weight would go down as the fuel burned, and it would go up if it rained and the rain soaked the covers. And just to make things worse, the weight had to be balanced across the ship, or it would tip forwards or it would tip backwards. So the airships were very complicated machines. They were very experimental and dangerous. But they were never treated that way. For example, the British built the R-101 airship. After barely testing it, the captain offered to take 100 members of parliament up for a joyride in this untested death trap. The airship had never been tested in bad weather, but that didn't stop them from sending it on a 10,000-mile journey from England to India with 54 people on board. 2 days into its first flight, it crashed, killing all but six of the passengers. Airships failed in many different ways. Their covers flew off, their gas bags popped, their hydrogen gas exploded. Many crashed on their very first voyage. Americans tried using helium instead of hydrogen, but those airships crashed too. Only after decades of tragic disasters were airships finally stopped. During that time, airplanes kept getting better and better. Airplanes got safer, faster, and far more comfortable. And that is how the airship idea was abandoned and forgotten. You probably noticed that I've started using some generative AI video tools. This is something I'm experimenting with. It's the first time I've done it. And I'm very curious what you think about it. I know many people have a very hostile reaction towards AI technology. And I think there are a couple reasons for this. First, AI is being used in a lot of very low quality, lazy work. So my promise to you is that I will always maintain the high standards that my fans expect. I will never use AI in any way to write any of the script, to narrate any of the video. Every word you hear is from me. Another concern is that AI will confuse people, so they won't know what's real and what's fake. I don't think the technology is quite that good yet, but to avoid any possible confusion, I've added a little AI watermark so you can tell when I'm using AI and when I'm not. Now, a third concern is that many people worry that AI is going to be used for all kinds of nefarious, evil purposes. Now, I share those concerns. It's something I'm quite worried about. But this technology is moving forward whether I like it or not. It can be used for good or for evil, just like any other tool. And I can use it for good. I can use it to tell true stories in a very visually compelling way. It's very imperfect. It makes lots of mistakes. I couldn't use most of the footage it produced. But when it does work, it's kind of magical and it's really fun to play with. So let me know what you think in the comments. And if you like my videos, please subscribe.